Good morning, students. Today our class is English and we will study a new chapter, unit number 4, The Ashes That Made Trees Bloom. This story is taken from a Japanese tale and it is a very beautiful story and have two parts. Today I will read first part and next class I will read second part. Let's start this beautiful story, The Ashes That Made Trees Bloom. But one thing, the word here is very, very difficult to understand. So if you not read textbook and underline the meaning, when I will tell you in the end of the reading, you must write it in your textbook, okay? Let's start unit number one, unit part one, The Ashes That Made Trees Bloom. In the good old days of Daimyos, Daimyos means landlord of Japan, there lived an old couple, couple means husband and wife, whose only pet was a little dog. Having no children, they loved it as though it were a baby. The old dame made it a cushion of blue crepe. Dame means here middle-aged woman. Old dame means middle-aged woman. The old dame made it a cushion of blue crepe. Crepe means one type of cloth and eat mealtime Muko, the name of the dog, for that was its name, would sit on it and snug as any cat. Snug means comfortable sitting or protected from cold and warm. Snug, S-N-U-G. The kind people fed the pet with tidbits, a type of food or fish from their own chopsticks and all the boiled rice it wanted, thus treated. The dumb creature loved it, protectors like a being with a soul. Dumb means here, dumb creature means the creature who cannot speak so much. The old man, being a rich farmer, went daily with hoe or spade into the field, working hard from morning until o tento sama. O tento sama means in Japan it is called sun, had gone down behind the hills. Every day the dog followed him to work, never once, go to next page, harming the white Heron means one type of bird that walked in the footstep of the old man to keep up the worms. Worms means kire mokore, what you say. For the old fellow was patient and kind to everything that had life and often turned up a sword. Turned up a sword means grassland, on purpose to give food to the birds. One day the dog came running to him, putting his paw against his leg and motioning with his head to some spot behind. The old man at first thought his pet was only playing and did not mind it, but the dog kept on whining means high pitched cry, and that means wow, 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 and running to and fro. To and fro means constant movement sideways for some minutes. Then the old man followed the dog a few yards to a place where the animal began a lively scratching. Scratching means, scratch. You scratch it. Thinking it was possibly a buried bone or bit of fish, the old man struck his hoe to the earth. Earth means here ground, when lo, a pile of gold gleamed before him, gleaming, shining. Thus, in an hour, the old couple were made rich. The good souls bought a piece of land, made a feast of their friends, and gave plentifully to their poor neighbors. As for the dog, they pitied him till they nearly smothered him with kindness. Now, in the same village, there lived a wicked, means very bad, cruel old man and his wife, not a bit sensitive and kind, who had always kicked and scolded all dogs whenever any passed their house. Hearing of their neighbor's good luck, they coaxed means borrowed or purchased the dog into their garden and set before him bits of fish and other dainties. Dainties means tasty food, hoping he would find treasure for them. But the dog, being afraid of the cruel pair means that husband-wife, would neither eat nor move. Then they dragged him out of doors, taking a spade and hoe with them. No sooner had the dog got near a pine tree growing in the garden, then he began to paw and scratch the ground as if a mighty treasure lay beneath means under the ground. "Quick, wife, hand me the spade and hoe," cried the greedy old fool, as he danced with joy. When the covetous means very greedy old fellow, covetous underline greedy, means covetous means greedy old fellow, with a spade and the old crone means old woman, with a hoe began to dig, but there was nothing but a death kitten, the smell of which made them drop their tools and shut their noses. Furious at dog, the old man kicked and beat him to death, and the old woman finished the work by nearly chopping off his head with the sharp hoe. Then they flung him into the hole and heaped the earth over the carcass. Carcass means dead body. The owner of the dog heard of the death of his pet and mourning for him as if he had been his own child, went tonight under the pine tree. He set up some bamboo tubes in the ground, such as are used before tombs, in which he put fresh flowers. Then he laid a cup of water and a tray of food on the grave and burned several costly sticks of incense. He mourned a great while over his pet, calling him many dear names as if he were alive. That night the spirit of dog appeared to him in a dream and said, "Cut down the pine tree over my grave and make from it a mortar for your rice pastry and a meal of your bean sauce." Meal means here, mortar means bowl, and meal here is wood. So the old man chopped down the tree and cut out of the middle of the trunk a section about 2 feet long. With great labor, partly by fire, partly by the chisel, he scraped out a hollow place as big as small bowl. He then made a long handle hammer of wood, such as is used for pondering rice. When New Year's time drew near, he wished to make some rice pastry. When the rice was all boiled, Granny put it into the mortar. The old man lifted his hammer to pound the mass into Domi's thick material, and the blows fell heavy and fast till the pasty was all ready for baking. Suddenly the whole mass turned into a heap of gold coins. When the old woman took the handmill and filling it with beans began to grind, the gold dropped like rain. Meanwhile, the envious neighbor peeped, looking quietly in at the window when the boiled beans were being ground. Goody me, cried the old hag. Hag means ugly old woman, as she saw each dripping of sauce turning into yellow gold, until in a few minutes the tub under the mill was full of shining mass of gold. So the old couple were rich again. The next day the stingy means miserly and weak neighbor came and borrowed the mortar and magic mill. They filled one with boiled rice and the other with beans. Then the old man began to pound and the woman to grind, but at the first blow and turn, the pastry and sauce turned into a foul mass of worms. Still more angry at this, they chopped the mill into pieces to use as firewood. The first part is completed. Second part I will read in next class. Okay. Thank you very much. I will give you workbook that you complete. Okay. And send me accordingly. Okay. Don't forget to send me your homework. Okay. Bye. See you.